Hey, just a quick note. After I've edited the video, I realized that this says it's about pivot table default formatting, but along the way, we discover some really crazy things that have never been on the podcast before. So check out those items down in the table of contents down in the YouTube description below. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2405. Can we control the default pivot table style? Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Gillen. Another question from my virtual seminar up at Columbus, Indiana. And it is dealing with how to control the default pivot table style from this gallery. Can we make all future pivot tables follow some certain rule? And before we talk about that, just realize that the colors in this gallery are controlled back here under page layout. If you choose a different color scheme, that's going to affect the colors that are in that gallery. So I'll come here to colors and choose something that is green. And then under design, you see that all of our choices are using those colors, right? So that's the first thing to realize. This gallery here is super annoying because they pretend that you can control this. Like if you right click, you can say set as default, right? And you think, oh, that's great. All future pivot tables that I create will now have those color schemes. You can even create your own color scheme back on the page layout tab to match the corporate branding. And now we're good to go. But set as default is deceptive. It's set as default for all future pivot tables that I create in this workbook, not all workbooks, right? So that isn't very useful at all. My solution for this is not perfect, but it's better than that, all right? So I'm just gonna do Control N first. We'll copy this original data here, just any data, something that you can create a pivot table from, Control C, Control N for new, Control V to paste. And go ahead and create a pivot table in this workbook. Insert pivot table, existing worksheet right here, click OK. Doesn't matter what you put in it, just anything. So you can come back here on the design tab. I guess first go to page layout and choose the color scheme that you want. Slipstream is what I'm gonna use. And then on the design tab, choose whichever format you think is the right one. I'll go with that. That way if I have two sets of items, I can have that alternating row, and you can choose banded rows or banded columns, your choice there. Then right click and set as default. What we're doing is setting a default for this book, book four. All right, now this is gonna sound crazy. Take all of your data and the pivot table, select it and delete. All right, so now we have a completely blank workbook, and the only thing that we've changed is the default pivot table. We're gonna go into File, Options, go to Advanced, scroll about halfway down in Advanced. There's a setting there that says at startup, open all files in. And right now on your computer, this is most likely blank. No one uses this. So we're gonna create a folder called Excel Start. You can call it whatever you wanna call it. So Excel Start, and then I'm gonna save this workbook into that folder with a special name. File, Save As. I'm gonna change the file type to either XLTM or XLTX. If you use macros, then use XLTM. If you don't, then XLTX. So I'll use XLTM. And be careful when you do that, they go to a certain folder and we wanna change that. Now check this out. I wanna change that. Normally I come down here and click Browse, but I just realized that I can click here as well. And that takes me into the old Save As dialog box. Excel Start. And I already have a file called book.xltm. Save over that. Okay, anyway, we have our book.xltm saved. All right, so now I can file close that. Now, the cool thing is anytime now that I use Control N to create a new workbook and I add some data to that, so I'll say rep Andy, grab the fill handle and drag, products, Apple, grab the fill handle and drag again, sales, and then when I create a pivot table, insert, pivot table, new worksheet, click OK, I will automatically get those colors and settings, right? It's not perfect. If someone else sends you a workbook, it's not gonna know that default, but at least for most of the workbooks that you start to create, that will be the default. Now, hey, while we're talking about pivot table formatting, just a real oddity here from one of the Excel MVPs named Wyn Hopkins. Wyn, check out his channel at YouTube. There's an I in the top right-hand corner at Access Analytic. He has great playlists on Power BI, Power Query, and General Excel. Check those out. Wyn was doing something else and stumbled upon this weird oddity. So we have a pivot table there, right? And if you come around the pivot table and add a border, like a thick outside border or something like that. Actually, I'm gonna go in and customize that even more. So I wanna show you exactly how this is working. I'm gonna choose a red border for the left. So we have a thick red border on the left. At the bottom, I'll use a green border and have it be dashed. So dashed blue. On the right-hand side, I'll use purple and have that be a dotted border. And then across the top, I guess we can use whatever we have not used yet, orange across the top. Is that orange? And one of these dashed and a dashed line across the top. Click OK. All right. So now we have this pivot table, and not touching the pivot table, but completely surrounding the pivot table is this weird border. And then change something in the underlying data and come into the pivot table and refresh. And oddly enough, the pivot table picks up the same borders that is surrounding it. So that blue border on the bottom becomes that horizontal line there. The border on top becomes every other horizontal border in the entire pivot table. The red line on the left becomes most of the vertical borders, but the purple line on the right becomes the rightmost border. Was this planned? Like, did someone actually code this up? What was the theory? I'm just guessing, it must have predated these pivot table design, and it might have been some way to very quickly apply some very unusual formatting. I don't know. I'm not sure that this is useful at all, just presenting it as an Excel oddity. Thanks to Wyn for noticing that and passing it along. It's a weird one. Hey, later this year, I'll be updating my book, Microsoft Excel Pivot Table Data Crunching. Check that book out. It has all kinds of great pivot table tips. Mike Alexander is my co-author, and as he likes to say, it is spicy. It has lots of spicy tips. Click the I in the top right-hand corner for more information about that. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.